Hello students, welcome to the English classroom. This is Anurag Sidhu, lecturer in English, Government Senior Secondary School, Ramgarh, Puddha. We will be doing this chapter in your book, A Panorama of Life, Section C, Chapter 5, Part 2, The Panch Parmeshwar. As we had already done some of it, we'll be doing the rest of the story in this session and also the question answers. As you all know, this is a story about two friends, Juman Sheikh and Algu Chaudhary. Munshi Premchand was born on 31st July 1880. He was a writer as well as a novelist. His notable works were Godan, Bazaar, A Husn, Karam Bhoomi, Gaban. He died on 8th October 1936. He wrote in Hindi and many of his works were translated into many languages. English is one of them. The Panch Parmeshwar summary we'll do again quickly. Juman Sheikh and Algu Chaudhary were very close friends. They were partners in cultivation. They trusted each other deeply. When Juman went to Makkah, he left his house under Algu's care, and likewise, when Algu went somewhere, Juman took good care of his house and his properties. They did not share the same religion, but they thought alike. They were friends. Juman Sheikh had an old aunt who had some property and no near relative other than Juman. So Juman convinced her into transferring her property in his name. Until the property was transferred and been registered, Juman gave his aunt sumptuous food and fine clothing, but the final stamping of the property put an end to this glorious period. Juman's wife Kariman started insulting her. She cursed her day and night, used harsh words, and did not treat her well, and did not give her enough food. At last, the aunt said to Juman that she will go to the panchayat and he should give her some money for her maintenance regularly so that she can cook her own food. So when she threatened her that she will go to the panchayat, Juman said, why not? Call the panchayat by all means. Let things be decided once for all. I don't like these everyday quarrels. So the woman went from village to village and house to house and told people to come for the panchayat. Then one day she went to Algu Chaudhary's door. She threw down her stick and sat down to rest. She said, son, you should also come to the panchayat meeting. Algu said, I shall come, but I won't open my mouth. Juman is my old friend. I can't go against him. So he promised that he will come, but he will not say anything against him. But aunt said, would you turn your back to justice just for the sake of your friendship? So one evening, the panchayat gathered under a tree. Juman Sheikh had already spread his sheet. He himself was sitting with Algu Chaudhary at some distance. The five members of the panchayat sat down and the old woman appealed to them. She narrated the whole story and said, I shall accept whatever you decide. The word of the panch is the word of Allah. I shall obey your order without questioning it. So they were asked to choose a sarpanch. So Juman was told by Ramdan Mishra, you choose a panchayat so that you have no objection later on. So he said, no problem, let auntie decide. So son, hope you trust Algu Chaudhary. She said, come on, I choose him as the sarpanch. Juman said, for me, Ramtan Mishra and Algu are the same. So when Algu Chaudhary was designated the sarpanch, he said, Juman Sheikh, you and I are old friends, but at this moment, we are not friends. You and your aunt are equal in my eyes. So Juman spoke in a very composed manner. He said, O members of the panchayat, 3 years ago, my aunt had transferred her property in my name, एंड आई हैड अग्रीड टू प्रोवाइड हर फूड एंड क्लोदिंग टिल हर डेथ. कहना आई हैव नॉट नेवर इल ट्रीटेड हर बट नाउ शी इज डिमांडिंग मनी फॉर हर मेंटेनेंस बट इट वॉज नॉट रिटन इन द मंथली एक्सपेंस इन द अग्रीमेंट. दैट्स ऑल आई हैव टू से. देन Algu began to cross-examine Jumman. Jumman was shocked at Algu's conduct. Finally, what happened was, he decided in favor of aunt. He says, aunt should be given a monthly allowance. This is the decision of the panchayat. And if this is not acceptable to you, then the agreement for transfer of property should be cancelled. Jumman was stunned to hear the decision. On the other hand, Ramtan Mishra and other members of the panchayat were praising Algu's decision. But Jumman felt cheated. So, their friendship ended here. Now what happened? On the other side, Algu had purchased a fine pair of oxen from Batesar. Unfortunately, one of the oxen died just a month after Jumman's panchayat. So, Jumman said, this is the punishment for his treachery. Now, a single ox was of no use to Algu, so Algu decided to sell it. Now, there was the beginning of another story now. In the same story, so there was this trader, Samju Sahu, who drove a single ox cart. He carried gur and ghee from the village to the market and returned with oil and salt, which he sold in the village. He looked at the ox, bargained the price, and finally bought it. He promised to pay the price within 1 month to Algu Chaudhary. So Algu Chaudhary agreed. Samju began to drive it hard. He made 3 to 4 trips every day without caring to feed the animal properly. He did not give it any rest, nor he fed it properly. Whereas at Algu's house, the ox had been looked after well, it was given fresh water to drink, he was given fodder and grain and even a touch of ghee. It was cleaned and massaged, but now it got weak and its bones became visible. One day, while on his fourth trip, Samju Sahu put a double load on him. Exhausted after the day's work, the ox was unable to lift his feet, but Sahu kept on whipping him. He tried to pick up pace, but his strength failed. Now the ox was so tired after 4 trips to and fro from the village, and there was much load on it. He collapsed and did not rise again. He fell down and fainted. Sahu whipped him mercilessly and the ox died. Sahu whipped him so that to make him get up and take the load home. But the ox was so tired and so drained of energy that it died. Samju had sold many sacks of gur and many tins of ghee and earned rupees 250. There were a few sacks of salt and tins of oil on the cart. So he decided to spend the night awake. He thought, let it be morning, let help come, and then only I can take my things home. He thought he had kept awake throughout, but when he opened his eyes at the break of day and touched his waist, he found the pouch containing the money missing. Several tins of oil were also missing. When Samju's wife heard the story, she first cried, then started cursing Algu Chaudhary. They started saying that Algu had given a sick oxen. So many months passed. Whenever Algu went to their house to ask for the price of ox, both husband and wife would start abusing him. They used to say, the ox was not well. He cheated us by giving a unwell ox. So both started abusing him. But it was not easy for Algu to give up his claim. ਹੁਣ ਅਲਗੂ ਵਾਸਤੇ ਇਹ ਤਾਂ ਮੁਸ਼ਕਿਲ ਸੀ ਨਾ ਕਿ ਉਹ ਆਪਣੇ ਪੈਸੇ ਛੱਡ ਦਿੰਦਾ. ਵਿਲੇਜਰਸ ਸੁਜੈਸਟਡ ਦੈਟ ਅ ਪੰਚਾਇਤ ਬੀ ਕਾਲਡ ਟੂ ਸੈਟਲ ਦਾ ਇਸ਼ੂ. ਸਮਝੂ ਐਗਰੀਡ. ਅਲਗੂ ਐਗਰੀਡ ਟੂ. ਦੋਨੋਂ ਜਣੇ ਇਸ ਗੱਲ 'ਤੇ ਉਹਨਾਂ ਨੇ ਇੱਕ ਫੈਸਲਾ ਹੋ ਗਿਆ ਕਿ ਠੀਕ ਹੈ, ਪੰਚਾਇਤ ਦੇ ਵਿੱਚ ਇਸ ਦਾ ਫੈਸਲਾ ਕਰ ਦਿੱਤਾ ਜਾਵੇ. ਪ੍ਰੈਪਰੇਸ਼ਨਸ ਫੋਰ ਦਾ ਪੰਚਾਇਤ ਬਿਗੈਨ. Both the parties began to look for their supporters. On the third day, the panchayat assembled under the same tree in the evening. The panchayat began its meeting. Ramtan Mishra said, Algu Chaudhary, whom do you elect? Algu said, let Samju Sahu choose. Samju stood up and said, I choose Jumman Sheikh. On hearing this, Algu's heart began to beat fast. Now Algu thought he had given a verdict against Jumman Sheikh and he was no longer his friend. And this is the reason why Samju also chose Jumman Sheikh. He thought Jumman Sheikh would give the judgment in Samju's favor because he will take revenge from Algu. So both were like, Samju was happy that he had given Jumman Sheikh to be the panch, sarpanch. So on hearing this, Algu's heart began to beat fast. He feared that Jumman might take his revenge. Jumman Sheikh also became conscious of such a responsibility. The moment he was given the high office of the sarpanch, now Jumman became the sarpanch. Now when he was given the responsibility, he thought, whatever I utter now would be like the word of God. I must not deviate even a bit from truth. Now Jumman Sheikh thought, whatever he says, people will have to agree to what he says, agree to his decision, to his verdict. Now, with responsibility on his shoulders, he thinks that he must not deviate from truth. He must, because his word will be like the word of God. Jumman heard both sides patiently. Which were the two sides now? It was Algu Chaudhary and Samju Sahu. The customer explained how he could make payments for something that did not even exist anymore. Who is the customer here? It is Samju Sahu. So the customer said, what he wants me to pay for? He wants me to pay for the ox which is not there. It's already died. So why should I pay for the dead ox? Algu explained that the bull was healthy when it was sold. The customer made him work hard without regard for its diet or health. He beat the bull mercilessly. Now Algu was saying that his bull or the ox was healthy when it was sold. Because it died because Samju did not take good care of it. In the end, Jumman announced the judgment. Algu Chaudhary and Samju Sahu, the panchayat has carefully considered your dispute. So the panchayat, Jumman announced to both of them, Algu Chaudhary and Samju Sahu, the panchayat has carefully considered your dispute It is proper that Samju should pay the price of the ox. The ox was healthy when he bought it. If the price had been paid then, the present situation would not have arisen. The ox died because he was forced to work too hard and was not properly fed. Algu Chaudhary was overjoyed. He stood up and shouted, "God bless the Sarpanch! God bless the Sarpanch!" So everyone admired Jumman's judgment. At the end, Jumman came to Algu and embraced him. And this was again the start of their friendship. Jumman said, "My brother, ever since you decided the case against me, I have been your deadly enemy. But today, I learnt as a Panch that I am neither anybody's friend nor anybody's foe. A Panch cannot see anything except justice. Today, I am convinced that God speaks through a Panch's lips." So here, there is this word, foe. What is foe? Foe is enemy. So he says that when a Panch is sitting on the chair where he has to make the decision, he cannot see anything except justice. It is right that I had become your deadly enemy. I thought I'll take revenge against you. But now I understand what, when you were in the same place, when you were a Panch, and you made a decision against me, I had become your deadly enemy. But now when I was at the same place, I am convinced that a Panch cannot see anything except justice. Today I am convinced that God speaks through a Panch's lips. So Algu began to cry. His tears washed away the misunderstandings that had accumulated in their hearts. So now both were happy. Algu began to cry because of happiness. So the tears washed away whatever bad feelings or misunderstandings they had towards each other's and had built up in their hearts. So we will do the questions now. We'll do the questions quickly. Some questions we had already done. I know you have done those from home, and we can see that the question is, what do you know about the friendship of Algu Chaudhary and Jumman Sheikh? They both enjoyed a deep friendship. They cultivated their lands jointly and trusted each other deeply. What was the problem of Jumman Sheikh's aunt? Old aunt? Yes, Jumman Sheikh's aunt decided not to live with the family because they ill-treated her after they got her property in their names. The third question is, why did Jumman laugh at the threat of the old aunt to take the matter to the village panchayat? Jumman laughed at the threat of the old aunt to take the matter to the village panchayat because he was confident that he would win the case. How did the villagers react when Jumman's old aunt contacted them about the meeting of the panchayat? They tried to console her. Even Algu refused to speak against his friend. So the fifth question is, how did Algu Chaudhary react when the old aunt went to him to request him to come to the panchayat meeting? He told her that he would attend the meeting but would not open his mouth. How did Jumman's old aunt present her case? She said that Jumman got her property transferred in his own name and then he and his wife had started ill-treating her. Whom did Jumman's old aunt nominate as the head panch? It was Algu Chaudhary. How did Jumman Sheikh become the enemy of his friend Algu Chaudhary? Jumman became the enemy of his friend Algu Chaudhary because at one panchayat meeting, Algu Chaudhary had given his decision against Jumman. Now, what was the matter of dispute between Algu Chaudhary and Samju Sahu? Yes, Samju Sahu bought an ox from Algu But after some time, the ox died and Samju refused to give the price for the ox. How did Algu Chaudhary and Jumman Sheikh become friends again? Jumman Sheikh was the head panch in Algu and Samju's case. He gave decision in Algu's favor. Everyone praised the decision. They became friends again because they had cleared their misunderstandings. So now let's come to the question 11. Write a note on the theme of the story. So what was the story now? What was the theme? Theme is of the mutual friendship of the people, two friends, Algu Chaudhary and Jumman Sheikh. They were friends, but they became enemies when the panch decided against Jumman Sheikh. But the story's actual theme is that the panch must be impartial. God speaks through him. He should see only the truth. The panch should not keep in mind friendship or enmity. The panch should not keep in mind friendship or and enmity or on enmity. In this story, both Algu and Jumman kept only truth before them while giving their decision. Because God speaks through him, he should see only the truth. He should not say that this is my friend and I have to give my decision in his favor, or he is my enemy and I have to give my decision against him. So the panch should not keep in mind friendship and enmity. Next question is, write a brief character sketch of Jumman Sheikh. So when we write a character of somebody, we can write in many ways. One of the ways is that is shown in front of you, and the other I'll explain after this. Jumman is the main character of the story. He was a close friend of Algu. Jumman was cunning by nature. He deceived his aunt. Jumman got her property transferred in his own name, but then he started ill-treating her. But when Algu decided the case against him, he became his enemy. So we can say that Jumman was a friend of Algu, but he deceived his aunt and the case was brought before Algu Chaudhary. Algu Chaudhary decided the case against him, so he became his enemy. He knew that he was wrong, but when Algu decided the case against him, he became his enemy. So let's see the next character sketch and then we will do it together. Now, a brief character sketch of Algu Chaudhary. Algu Chaudhary is one of the main characters, main in the story. He was a close friend of Jumman. He is simple at heart. He is impartial. In Jumman's aunt's case, he gave a fair decision. Then Jumman became his enemy. But later in Algu's case, Jumman gave his decision in Algu's favor. They became friends again. So this is how the story developed. Now, what is the significance of the title of the story? The title of the story is very significant. It tells us about the Panch Parmeshwar. Panch means five. Panch Parmeshwar. So, five people make a panchayat. It means that Panch is like God. Panch is total, the team is like God. He is impartial. He is इम्पार्शियल, वो किसी दे पक्ष नहीं लैंदा, हो ना एनिमी दा ना हो पक्ष लैंदा हैगा अपने फ्रेंड दा. गॉड स्पीक्स थ्रू देम, ही शुड सी ओनली द ट्रूथ. द पंच शुड नॉट कीप इन माइंड फ्रेंडशिप एंड एनमिटी. इन दिस स्टोरी बोथ अलगू एंड जुम्मन केप्ट ओनली ट्रूथ बिफोर देम, सो द टाइटल ऑफ द स्टोरी इज अप्रोप्रिएट बिकॉज थ्रू देयर वर्ड्स it was decided, the whole decision was taken by the Panches. So they thought that the decision of the Panch is like the decision of God. It means that Panch is like a God, he is impartial, God speaks through them, so he should see only the truth. So there are two decisions made. In both the decisions it was the God spoke through them, and it was just their truth which came forward without considering friendship or enmity. So the story shows that the Panch should not keep in mind friendship and enmity, and it was like the word of God, Panch Parmeshwar. So this was the story. And these photos have been taken from Google Co-in for educational purpose only and from YouTube. It is prepared by Arvind Kumar, lecturer in English, Government Girl Senior Secondary School, Saidowal Khurd, Gurdaspur, and presented by Anurag Sidhu, lecturer in English, Government Senior Secondary School, Ramgarh Pudda, SAS Nagar. This is an initiative of the Department of School Education, Punjab. See you next time with another topic. Thank you so much. Keep learning. Keep happy. Thank you. Till next time. Bye-bye.